What's up? It's your boy, Tantalizing Turbo Toe, back at it again with the exploiting my girlfriend's account for content. Yeah. I hear boss music. We got to get Mona back up in here. Let's see how much progress we've made. We still have the level 80 Solar Pearl. Artifacts, I think, are more or less the same. She may have been looking at her a little bit and swapping some things out, because don't think we had this plus zero. Oh, that's right. She instantly gave Vinti the thing we stole back, I remember. But everything else, I think... No, I don't think she had a lava walker. Oh, yeah, the energy recharge. The pretty pog energy recharge. And this... Yeah, this was actually from Water Dude, I believe. Whatever, regardless. How about talents? Because that's, like, the worst thing. Okay, they're all still... how about Stellaris Phantasm? Okay, we do have some talent books, which is pretty cool. I don't know how many of the weekly boss... Yeah, we don't have much of the weekly boss mats, unfortunately. We're probably going to get Phantasm up to 10. Oh, it would be the same stuff Klee needs, though. I mean, she already has level 10 Jumpty Dumpty. What else do you need? And I don't think really anyone else that she has raised needs them, so we're probably going to go for it. First, we're going to make all we can... Oh, yeah, they save that now. That's Pog, so I don't have to switch that all the time. We definitely will have to go for quite a few books. This is enough to get her ult to 10, I guess. We can already try her out a little bit. We're gonna give her this back though, sorry Vint boy. And we're gonna go ahead and get that up to 10. We can already start using her, basically just her ult though. Here are her current details. Crit rate again is still kinda low. We didn't really do much with the artifacts actually. But 101 Hydro damage bonus, that is pretty pog by itself. Considering you have pretty much zero of these books, and her talents are still level, what the hell, 1600? How many Whopper Flowers have you murdered though? We're gonna go ahead and go to Frozen Abyss 1 just to make it a bit quicker. That was a joke, please don't have a heart attack. Electro is recommended, and since Vinti has been stripped of his powers, we're just gonna go Razor. Mona is pretty pog to get up here quick. She's not actually the best for this place, however, so, yeah, we can't really test her out that well here. She has been working on her Klee as well, though. Watch this. Boom. 31k crit. Also, someone was judging me on how I play Klee. I don't own Klee, so... What? Let's go ahead and try and ult anyway. Was that like a 12k? That wasn't that impressive. Okay, there was a 31k because it was a crit. Can you please stop? I hate this domain so much. Oh man, and our Klee died. All right, it's time to get serious. Razor, with your R2 Wolf's Gravestone, teach them who is actually the boss here, please. Yeah, but Razor is an absolute beast. I mean, look at these dudes just, I don't think they're even superconducted. Well, as far as I know from Mona, her main sort of utility comes from the amp more than just the damage itself. So obviously we're gonna try and do her ult and then do someone else's like ult, maybe Hu Tao or something might be pretty good. Although I don't think her Hu Tao is built super well right now. She couldn't get the Homa, which is a very unfortunate thing. Wait, what were those numbers? Klee? Klee, no! What do we got here? Of course, still no good books. Pog. What do we got here? C1 Hu Tao would actually be amazing here, since you're constantly out of stamina. I cannot even describe how much I hate this dungeon. Well, with our two damage dealers dead, we're probably gonna have to leave anyway. And still no purple books. Superb. Or should it be... Supog? Anyway... Probably gonna go ahead and start with her E. I think it's a pretty nice skill also. And we're out. Can also do her normal attack. A little bit at least. Up to 6, I guess. But yeah, we'll definitely need some more runs. Her Hu Tao is actually using Dragon's Bane, which might actually be super good here because constantly, you know, ice slimed and all. Attributes as a whole could be a little bit better, but then I'm kind of also ignoring the 450 Elemental Mastery up there. So that's the reason that I guess the other stats are a little bit... lesser. Mine has like no elemental mastery. So yeah, we're gonna try Hu Tao. We do need some more condensed resin, however. Sorry, Klee, I kinda suck with you. I would like to do Mona ult, Hu Tao ult on some naked slimes. Alright, let's give this a try. Maybe. I think we got 109 there. Yeah, I mean, Mona's damage doesn't get better, but I think there's some kind of amp there. I'll have to look at her skill description again. Purples, purples. Yeah, there we go, at least one. No,
Baraka.
I didn't have time to heal. Guess we can compare that to no Mona ult. Oh, well, that wasn't a crit, so it's kind of hard to compare. Why is her attack speed so fast? And what are those did you give her flute bones? Thought she had sacrificial. Actually doesn't say anything about increasing attack speed. Did Chi-Chi always attack that fast, though? Oh yeah, it says 5-second omen duration, which happens after, and I guess with the attack that hits them when they're trapped in that little weird constellation-looking stuff. I mean, a pocket of destiny. But yeah, a 60% damage bonus for 5 seconds is a pretty crazy amp, and it still has 3 levels to go. Unfortunately, I believe level 10 is the max, so having C3 basically just saves some books unless you really want the extra bubble explosion damage, which, you know, is good, is nice. It's a lot of damage, especially if you have a really well-built Mona, but I don't know if it's really worth, you know, raising it as a priority. So I might spend those, actually. I don't know if I even will. Maybe I'll just get these 2 to 6 and call it a day, and have Bones decide what to do later. And with that decision, we're gonna claim these final rewards. We're probably gonna save those last 3 condensed resin because we probably have enough to get the others to 6, especially because we got a philosophies of wait, we don't need the purple ones anymore. All right, here we go. Let's try this again. No, no, what the? I hate this dungeon beyond words, I swear to God. No, no, switch back, you're not healed yet. And now she doesn't have her ult anymore. What do we got here? No purples. Well, I mean, it still would be nice to get purples, actually. All right, let's try and see this now. Finally, that was a crit, and it did 50k. With Mona's buff, it did like over 100. I'm not sure exactly, because it said 60%, and that seems more like 100%, but there could be some other factors there. She may have been under 50% HP, giving her that other buff she gives. There's always so many dang variables. This also isn't really the best place to test Mona in general. Just a bunch of ice slimes. It's kind of annoying, honestly. Are you serious? Just let me... Anyway, this should be the last one we need. Yeah, wait. Yeah, we'll be able to craft one more silver. And there we go. I think that's all we're going to do for now. But yeah, 6-6-10. Her ult being the most important thing, obviously. I think it's fine. I think it's good. Her artifacts, I'm not really sure what I could do with. As far as I remember, I kind of did already the best I could. Her artifacts don't really have enough crit rate, unfortunately. Or just like going off piece instead of hydro damage bonus, but that's never that great of an idea unless you can really get some awesome artifacts instead. Guess we can use this transformer. I think that there's a chance to get some. Gonna use some of these 1000 whopper flower nectars. Wait, I thought it was only 100. Is it just me, or does it seem like everyone is attacking so much faster than usual? Like, look at how fast Razor is attacking, dude. That doesn't look normal. Maybe I'm just tired and everything looks faster for whatever reason. No, we didn't get anything. So we're back. I went to sleep. I'm not really sure if there's anything else to go over with Mona. I'm still not totally satisfied with her artifacts. And this is back on Venti. I'm not totally sure if she needs Oblige. I mean, yeah, it does a lot of damage, so Oblige is good, but it's like, eh, I don't know, because, you know, I think the biggest thing is the amp she gives, the 60% damage bonus. I think 2 really good off pieces in exchange for that 20% ult damage might make her slightly better overall, especially because I can't just keep stealing this off of Venti anyway. Let's start with the circlet. Let's raise it a little bit at least. Crit rate, elements of mastery. It went to HP. Let's give up on that for now. There are none with at least 3 good subs. So we're starting with the ones that have 2 good subs, and it starts with 4. So it has a higher potential. Oh, I think we're out of upgrade materials again, more or less. You can throw like a +3 in there, see where it goes. HP again. Well then, for now we're just going to take this back off of Venti. Probably just going to fight a couple ruin guards, to be honest. That's generally a pretty good test. We can just try, you know, solo Mona, see how she does. So here are some basic attacks. It's not that horrible. How about a charged? Yeah, 6k for a charged. Let's go ahead and try that E. Get a Q in there. Yeah, I mean, she can deal with ruin guards pretty quick, you know. She's definitely not built much as a main DPS, but she can take care of that Ruin Guard. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Well, in my opinion, at least how she's currently built, she shines a lot more as a support. So I think we're going to get, like, Klee in here. Going to her E, her Q, swap out to Klee and just start bashing on him. Let's see how that works out. So boom, because now he has the Omen burst and he is getting obliterated with that 60% Omen damage bonus. And before I could even finish my sentence, he is dead, of course. So yeah, you know, Mona go burr. I really don't know what else to say. Bones will have to decide if she's going to use Mona or not. I would say she definitely should. If not just for the ult and the 60% damage bonus for those 5 seconds after the bubble bursts. I'm using her E a lot with Ganyu to get the frozen status, you know, from a range. I know like Water Dude can apply wet more consistently, but you have to be really close to them. So I'm actually usually starting with Ganyu, doing her E, going to Mona, doing her E, and then swapping back to Ganyu and just wailing on him for a bit. And because Ganyu has the Cryo set there, you know, hitting frozen enemies is always quite pog for that extra crit rate. And you know, once that whole cycle is over, you can just go back and the E is pretty much off cooldown and then start it again. And that's pretty much that little cycle. You know, of course, I'm going to be switching to my other characters and doing things also, but just those two pair pretty well together, in my opinion. But yeah, that's basically how I'm using her. And, you know, she has Ganyu. Her Ganyu is kind of raised also, so it's like, you know, think about it, Bones. But I guess that will do it for today's video. Make sure to tell me what you think in the comments down below. Dropping a like on this video if you did happen to enjoy is always greatly appreciated as well. Thanks, as always, for watching, and until next time.